Was that just like you dreamed it in your driveway? Or?
I mean, I just told my captain, Kevin, I said, look, trust me on this one. Just drive, kick it out to me, and I got us. And he trusted me, so.
Did you guys see the end of the JV game? Because it ended the same way.
Yes, I was here for that one. Calvin, Wash hit the game winner for them, and I got loud.
Yeah. What's that got to feel like? This, you know, Riverside really needed that win.
I mean, it feels great. It's my senior night. I mean, I had a lot of fans here, my family, everybody here to watch that. I mean, it feels great.
Now, you had a three in the first quarter, but nothing else after that. Still, you wanted the ball?
Yes. I mean, the rim, it wasn't – no shots was falling for me today, but I had confidence and I had trust and faith in myself, so it fell.
It looked like you ran all the way to the other side. Were you scared of getting caught in the bottom of the pile?
Yeah, I had a feeling that it was going to be a storm, so I just went to the back just to, you know, have some support by the wall.
Did you steal that play from your JV coach?
No. You know what? I wasn't even in the gym when the JV game ended at all. And I just heard the crowd go wild. And they said that one of our kids hit a game-winning three. And I'm like, wow, you know, that's great. And it just so happened that, you know, I was just told in the locker room that it was the same exact shot. So very, very weird, very eerie.
Now, Phil hit his first shot and then struggled the rest of the day.
Right.
But he said he wanted the ball. He told the guys, I want the ball, I'm going to make it.
That's what makes him such a good team captain and a team leader. He knows his role. This is his second game winner, as he said, of the year. And clutch time, he wants the ball in his hands. And that's the true sign of a leader and a basketball player.
Now Riverside made a great run in the second half and gave you total fits throughout the entire second half.
Right.
You almost have to feel for them because they haven't won yet and they were that close.
Right. They played really hard at the beginning of the third. They went on like a 10-0 run.
Yeah.
It was really nothing that I could think of that could stop the bleeding. They wanted it real bad. And so did we, I think, in the first half.
Yeah.
But coming out the gate second half, they were a totally different team.
How good does this feel? It's the kind of thing that's going to help you come March when the playoffs roll around.
I hope so. I think the momentum from this game will help us, and hopefully we can, you know, make some things happen come March 1st, not 3rd, 1st.
Obviously, in the second half, you did a great, great job of getting yourselves back into the game. It just, the game was a second too long for you guys.
Yeah, you know, we were down by 10 at halftime, and we were really proud of the way the kids came out and played in the second half. You know, we thought there were loose balls that we didn't get, and we really challenged them to step up and get those loose balls, and they did. And we came out, and we got ourselves a lead, and played one of the best quarters we've played all year. When you think about our record, I give our kids all the credit in the world for coming out and not holding their head down and believing in themselves. And you know, I've told them a number of times, I don't care about the record. We've gotten better. And anybody that's seen us play this year believes that. We've really gotten better and shown a lot of improvement. We came out and, you know, I told them not to let 5.8 seconds determine, you know, their view on the season or even the way we played tonight, because it's a tough play. You know, but they made a play. They made a great shot. And we played our hardest, and they just made a play when they needed to.